session on the opening day of Sankalp on the topic of scaling blended finance in India. So two areas where we're going to really focus on today. One is skilling and employment, and the other is, of course, healthcare.
In India, one of the problems of the skilling market, which is why there has been doubts about the efficacy and the effectiveness of the interventions, has been the fact that there seems to be a mismatch between the level of demand quality and the supply quality of skilling. We believe there are two things that needs to happen. One is the market needs to move towards more specialized higher-end skilling, which really creates skills which can command a reasonable amount of compensation in the market and therefore allow people who go through that process to be invested in their careers in those kind of areas. The second is, this market can only be scalable finally when beneficiaries pay for it.
So we have recently partnered with the British Asian Trust as co-investors, co-risk investors, to launch the first of its kind impact bond, which is called the Beyond COVID Skill India Impact Bond. And through this bond, we aim to tackle various challenges, particularly that have arisen in the wake of the pandemic as well. And also, given the gender focus of one of our outcome funders, through this SIB, we will be able to particularly focus on improving skilling and employment outcomes for women.
Many of the surveys on startups in healthcare and the progress of the healthcare in this space have reaffirmed the fact that the biggest stumbling block is lack of access to appropriate capital. So much so that 85% of the capital comes in the form of equity, leaving only 15 or less percentage space for debt or hybrid, which is very emerging.
Interacting with various organizations like Asha Impact and some consultants like Palladium, who has been implementing first social impact bond in Rajasthan, after knowing that model, it shows us a window of opportunity for government also to come as an impact funder in a sector which has or poses higher amount of risk in its implementation.
There is a lack of investable opportunities, but if we use blended finance approaches, we can address that. And the second is, it's really important to note that there is no silver bullet solution for all sectors and all types of interventions. So we really must adopt the model that is best suited and then adapt it to be fit for purpose.
Thanks to all of you. Thank you to Sankalp for hosting us, and look forward to continuing this dialogue.